everybody. Happy hump day. It's Penguin, and welcome to the kitchen. I'm Penguin, and the chef is watching Star Trek. He's watching Star Trek because this is a recipe that I just kind of wing it on my own. Made it for many, many years. It's very simple. Besides your salt and pepper, there's only four ingredients. It's going to be something that a lot of people are going to love with Memorial Day coming and 4th of July. This is my nephew's absolute favorite. And every time we have a gathering or a cookout, he always asks me to make it. I call it my Miracle Whip cheesy potatoes, but we're not using Miracle Whip. Everything we use is pretty much going to be the off-brand, but it's going to have the same taste. These are things that we have tried and we like compared to the name brands. So what you're going to need for this recipe is I've got about 8 medium russet potatoes right here. I have some Walmart brand of whip dressing or Miracle Whip. I also have the Walmart brand. If you can see this, this is their melt and dip. This is the Walmart brand of Velveeta. To me, this is just as good, if not better than Velveeta, and the price is sure a lot better. I think this is under $5 compared to Velveeta. That's more like $7 or $8. And it melts the same. And like I said, it just tastes just as good, if not better. And we're also going to need, I've got a pack of bacon here. And we're going to be using about 5 slices of this bacon. So I'm going to cut this up into pieces, put it in the frying pan, and I'm just going to lightly fry it just to get it a little golden brown. And I'm going to do that here in just a minute. And then we're going to use our new potato peeler that we got from our subscriber and our dear friend Darlene. And I'm going to peel up some potatoes. And yes, I still have my mom's potato knife here. So that way, if I need to cut eyes out, you know what I mean. Eyes out of the potatoes, then I can use this. Even though this also has the little pointy piece on it. So really, I probably don't need the other knife at all. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to get my frying pan here, which I do have it in my colander sitting right here. I'm going to get this package of bacon open, and I'm going to cut up some bacon pieces. Okay, guys, I took out about 5 pieces of bacon out of my package, and I'm just going to cut it into pieces here into my pan with my kitchen shears. This is the easiest way to do it, actually, instead of cutting it with a knife on a cutting board, because we're going to be separating them anyway or as they cook, because we just want bite-sized pieces of bacon. So we're just going to cut this up, make sure we don't get in our fingers cut up in it, too. We don't want no finger pieces in it. No, sir. This isn't a fast food restaurant. So I hope everybody's had a good Wednesday, a good hump day. Memorial Day is around the corner. Does anybody have any big plans for Memorial Day? I think with COVID still going on, I mean, I know it just varies. Numbers are higher in some spots, lower in others. They've pretty much made it so people don't have to wear a mask anymore, which is kind of has mixed feelings around everywhere. They had it on the news last night, and there was a lot of people that were still determined they're going to wear their mask, and me and the chef are 2 of those people, because even though the numbers are getting better in spots, we still don't feel safe, and we have yet to get vaccinated, which we will be this week. So that's the plan anyway. Myers has a walk-in COVID vaccination clinic. And if they're giving the Moderna, then we're going to go ahead and get vaccinated. All right, so I'm going to, whoops, I had a piece of Bannon ship. I'm going to go ahead and get this on the burner. I'm not going to show you guys how to fry this up. I'm sure you guys have fried bacon a million times. I'm just going to get it lightly cooked up. I'm not going to fry it until it's a hard, crispy bits of nothing. But when I get it done, I'll show you. In the meantime, I'm also going to get some potatoes peeled, so we'll be right back. I just want to show you guys for a minute, because with bacon, a lot of times people don't like to fry bacon because of the splatter and stuff. When I fry bacon, one of the things I do is I take a piece of foil and tear it off, and I cover my pan with it. Sorry if it steams up the camera. That way it keeps the splatter to a minimum. And when I'm done with my bacon, I just invert the foil. I put some paper towel on it, and then I take my bacon pieces and I put it on that. So it's just a tip that I use when I'm cooking up bacon. So I'll be right back with you. Okay, just showing you guys what I'm talking about. I just inverted my aluminum foil, put some paper towel on there, and put my bacon pieces on there. So I'm just going to set my bacon pieces aside for now. Let them sit over there. And the next thing we're going to do is we are going to peel up some potatoes. So, mind you, I haven't used a potato peeler for a long time, as Chef was talking about, because our potato peeler just wasn't very good. So this is the first time I'm actually getting to use a good potato peeler. So, and let me tell you, just that one first, look how smooth that is. Darlene, thank you so much, because my other potato peeler would just twirl around everywhere. And it was not fun to use at all. But look at this, guys. Is this not simple or what? Sure does make peeling a potato a lot easier. Woo-wee! This thing actually goes where it's supposed to go. And it peels how it's supposed to peel. I'm excited about that. Thanks, Darlene. You made peeling potatoes a lot easier for me. So I'm just going to keep you guys on camera while I finish peeling these up. Okay, guys, that made fast work of peeling those potatoes. Would you look at that? And like no waste on these. I mean, that is like thin potato skin right there. Darlene, thank you again so much. Now, this recipe is one that's kind of versatile. You can do anything you want to with it. As me and Chef always say, we give you the base. You can do anything you want. If you want to add onions and garlic to this, you can. You can fry them up in your bacon grease. If you don't want to use bacon, you can fry up about a pound of ground beef and drain it. You can use ground beef instead. If your kids don't like bacon, they don't like ground beef, and you want to cut up some hot dogs, then cut up some hot dogs and lightly fry them and drain them off and put them in this. It's really totally up to you what you want to do with it. So let me get my cutting board empty, and we'll be right back. I just still can't get over how smooth it was to peel those potatoes. I gotta pull my sleeves up a little bit, guys. So now I'm just gonna cut my potatoes. You wanna try to get them all in about the same size pieces. Bite size. We're gonna boil these up. Once I get them cut and washed, we're gonna put them in a pot, cover them with some cold water. We're gonna salt the water. And we wanna boil them until they're just fork tender. I mean, we don't want them, we don't want mashed potatoes. We want them until they're just barely fork tender. Like when you put a fork into them, they don't really mash, they more break. So I'm gonna get the rest of these cut up. Again, this is something that you can take to a cookout, a carry-in, make it for your family. It's great for the holidays when people are having cookouts. My nephew, he's always asking me to please make this. Even now that he's older and he's married, he just still always asks if I can make this. And that boy knows how to cook. I think we about got all these cut up. Make sure. Because you know, have you ever drained your potatoes and you've got that one potato that's just kind of wandering down there and you can't believe you missed it? Got some of these that are just a little big, so I'm just gonna cut them up a little bit. There's really no rhyme or reason to the size, just bite-sized pieces of potato. We want them to, you know, we want them to be mostly uniform, so that way they all cook at about the same time. All right, guys, I'm going to get these washed up. I'm going to get them in my pot of water. I'm going to get them boiled, and when they get to just barely fork tender, then we'll be back to assemble this. Okay, if you guys can see, I've got my potatoes in the pot. Now, I brought them up to boil, and after they started boiling, I turned my burner down to medium-low, and I'm going to let them cook. I'm just keeping my spoon on top of here, and when they get to just barely fork tender, I'll take them off, and I'll let you know about how long that took. Okay, while my potatoes are boiling over there, I'm going to keep an eye on them. I'm going to go ahead and cut up our cheese so we have it ready. This is a 2-pound block, and I'm going to use just about half of this for my potatoes. If you're using a whole 5-pound bag of potatoes, then you're going to want to use a whole 2-pound block of cheese. But we're going to use half. Again, you can make it your own if you want to add taco seasoning to it. You want to add onions, bell peppers. You can do anything like this, but this is one of those recipes that I just found to be just as good if you just keep it simple. You don't have to add all that other foo-foo stuff to it to make it really, really good. So I've cut about half of this. I absolutely love this cheese. It just melts so smooth, has a good flavor. If I were to blindfold somebody, I don't think they'd be able to tell the difference between this and actual Velveeta. So I'm just going to cut this into some squares. And I'm going to dump it into my bowl. I'm looking forward to this. Chef decided he was going to have a steak for dinner. So I was trying to figure out what I can do for a side instead of just a traditional baked potato. Because, you know, you can only eat so many baked potatoes. And I asked him if he'd want to have some of these because we haven't had any for a while. And his eyes lit up real big. And he's like, yeah, if you feel like making them. And I said, yep. I said, we'll just make a video out of it. We'll kill multiple birds with one stone. No offense to my little friend Birdie over there at Bird's Nest because we love her. Absolutely. Just going to cut this up. We have so much stuff going on. We've got a couple of appointments tomorrow. I have a cake that I want to make a video for. And like I said, Memorial Day is coming up. We need to get some flowers so we can... I want to go to my parents and brother and put some flowers on there. They're entombed. They're not buried. They're in a mausoleum. So I want to take some flowers and then we need to take some flowers to the chef's dad's gravesite and just a few different things like that. So, all right, I'm going to set this off to the side somewhere. Hang on, guys, I'll be right back. Okay, I just checked our potatoes and we've got about another 5 minutes on those. So I'm going to bring my bowl over here that's got my cut up cheese in it. And I'm going to grab my bacon over here. Sorry about my arm. And I'm just going to take almost all of my bacon. I'm going to take 2/3 of my bacon and put it in here. Just going to save just a little bit for the top. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my whipped dressing and open it up. And I may need to add more, but I'm going to start out putting about, probably about 3/4 of a cup of salad dressing in here. You'll know how dry it is or how moist it is and whether you want more. And like I always say, a good cook has to taste their food before they feed it to someone else. So we will taste it before it actually goes into the oven. But I'm going to do about 3/4 of a cup of this right now. And I'm just going to go ahead and get this mixed up in here. I am going to add just a little bit of salt and some pepper, but not until after I have my potatoes in here. If you want to do more bacon, you can do more bacon. The more bacon, the better, obviously. If you want to add green onions, you can do that. But there again, a lot of people don't like onions, and we just want to keep it simple. the bacon and the cheese has so much flavor that you're really not going to miss anything else being in there. And hey, ladies and gents, let's just admit it. The less work you have to do, the better, right? So I'm just going to wait. We're going to check on our potatoes. And as soon as they're done, I'm going to drain them. I'm going to go ahead and get my oven preheated to 350 degrees. And I already have my oven on 350 degrees. Sorry, guys. One step ahead. But you will want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Hence the reason why I say you want to make sure the potatoes are barely fork tender, because we're also going to be baking this in the oven. So as soon as the potatoes are ready, I'm going to get them drained. I'm going to rinse them in some cold water, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, our potatoes are done. And if I can show you what I mean, I'm going to take one out here. When I stick my fork in it, it has just a little bit of resistance, but it breaks. It doesn't actually smash. So that's what we're looking for. So I'm going to get my potatoes, and I'm just going to dump them in here into my cheese and bacon. Get my spoons over there. Get this in the sink, and I'll be right back. Okay, we've got our steamy bowl of potatoes here, and I just noticed something. Ooh, see how huge that spoon looks when it's turned at that angle? I was like, good Lord. That looks like a spoon made for a giant. So we're going to stir this up with our cheese and our bacon. I'm going to go ahead, because I know we're definitely going to need pepper. So I'm going to go ahead and get pepper into here. I'll probably use a good teaspoon of pepper, but depending on who you're feeding this to, if they have an intolerance to spicy or little kids. But you know me and the chef, we like our pepper. I'm going to get this all stirred up into that cheese and let the cheese get started melting in here. All those little cubes of that cheese is going to melt down as it's baking. It's going to get bubbly. It's going to be a nice bowl of yummy goodness. If you don't like Miracle Whip, or you don't like salad dressing, you can use mayonnaise instead. You don't have to use Miracle Whip. Again, and I can't say it enough, we just give you the base and then you run with it. If you don't like it exactly the way it is, then you can tweak it and turn it into anything you want. It's very versatile. So I'm just going to take a little taste. I want to see if I've got enough Miracle Whip in here, or if I need to add some salt. Hot potato. Okay. I am going to add a little bit more Miracle Whip, probably about a half a cup of Miracle Whip in there, and that ought to be plenty. And I am going to add little bit of salt, probably about a teaspoon of salt. I know it seems like a lot, but it's really not with all those potatoes. So, all right, gonna give this a stir, and I know it's gonna be ready after this. I'm not gonna need to add anything else into it. So I'm gonna finish getting it stirred up. When I get ready to put it into my casserole dish, then I'll bring you back. Okay, guys, got my casserole dish here. I'm just going to give this a light spray. And you know me, I always take a paper towel and I wipe around just to get the excess out. I don't need too much, and I run it up on the sides. Now we're going to take our potato goodness and we're going to dump it into our pan. Oh, all that cheese and potatoes and that bacon, Miracle Whip, well, salad dressing. Doesn't that look so good, guys? Whoo! Your family is going to love you for this one. You can have this on the side with barbecued chicken, or if you're having pork chops for dinner, anything like that. I'm going to scrape that out a little bit, but my hands are getting slippery on the bowl. Just going to get this all spread out here. Oh, my goodness. I'm so looking forward to this. I haven't made this for a long time. And I would save it for Memorial Day, but I know that our family's not going to be getting together too much on Memorial Day. Not this year. So, because my one brother and sister-in-law, they're getting ready to, they're getting their vending trailer ready because they're going to be setting up this weekend. So, everybody's got things that they need to get done. We'd more get together for 4th of July and Labor Day when we can. Okay, guys. Now, got that all in there. If you could smell it, it smells so good. Sorry about my arm again. I'm going to take our last bit of bacon. Just going to sprinkle our bacon all over the top. We don't need too much because we've got all that bacon on the inside too. Dump our bacon crumbs on there. And then we can just dispose of this. No fuss, no mess. This piece didn't really get cut up too much, so I'm just going to spread it out a little bit. All right. I am going to get this in the oven. We're going to let this bake for about 45 minutes. That's usually how long I bake mine, between 40 and 45 minutes, just till it gets bubbly, just slightly golden brown. And when it's done, we're going to bring you back. We're going to, I got a piece of bacon that abandoned ship. We're going to bring you back and we're going to taste this stuff. So we'll see you in just a bit. There it is, guys. Hot out of the oven. And if you can see, it's still bubbling around the edges. See the bubbles? Nice golden brown. Smells so good. We're just going to let this sit here for a few minutes before we dish it up. But we're excited to eat some because it smells so good. And it's so simple to make, guys. So we'll be back in just a bit. Okay, guys, there it is. All dished out and plated up. Nice and cheesy with all the bacon. I topped it with a little parsley and a little extra pepper. So I'm gonna take a bite. You see these? This is the best part, those little golden brown little niblets right there. It's so good. Get a bite. Piece of bacon on there. Here you go, guys. Would you like a nice cheesy bite? It's really hot. That's for sure. Got a blow on it. Isn't that right, Chef? He's got him a steak cooking because Chef's going to have some steak with his taters. He's a very tired boy today.
Too hot to eat yet.
Woo! It's hot. First thing you get is the bacon. Light bacon flavor. The cheese. And just a little bit of that extra little tangy, just a subtle tangy zip from the our version of Miracle Whip. Highly recommend this, guys. This will go along with anything. It's a delicious meal. Highly recommend it. And I'm going to end this video for now. We'll be back with another video probably tomorrow. You know us.
Memorial Day is coming up like you told them earlier. So we got some recipes for things you can cook for Memorial Day, indoors, outdoors. And
yeah, Chef's got a couple of recipes coming up himself for Memorial Day that I get to sit back and watch and enjoy because I get to eat it. So we will see you guys in another video. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.